Thank you so much for doing this, by the way.
Yeah, no problem.
I know that you're very busy, so this means a lot to me.
I am, yeah.
I like how you own that. You're like, no, it's fine, I'm not busy. You're like, I am, and you're welcome. Okay. I don't cry, I've never cried. I've only cried twice.
In your life?
Yeah.
Shut up.
Really?
Once when little Sebastian died.
You're a joke.
Hi, I'm Burke Collins.
I'm Amanda Silver.
And this is five things about Visual Studio Code. Number one, Visual Studio Code is a free text editor from Microsoft. And it's quite popular. But why create another text editor? Do we really need another text editor?
Well, I mean, there are a lot of text editors out there, but we found that there was this niche that was underserved with for code editors that had a good code understanding. So, you know, as you typed, it gave you good IntelliSense and things like that, but also debugging capabilities. So that's why we created VS Code.
Okay, and it's open source.
It is open source.
Now, are you taking pull requests?
We do take pull requests.
But you haven't taken my pull request.
What was your pull request?
Well, mine was to rename it to Visual Studio Burke.
I told you I would only do this if you weren't self-promoting.
Oh, I'm sorry. Would you like a Goo Goo Cluster?
What is a Goo Goo Cluster?
It's like a chocolate candy thing from Nashville.
Chocolate's good. Okay. Try that.
I think mine has marshmallow, peanut, and caramel. Number two, Visual Studio Code is based on Electron, so it's essentially a complex website?
Not really, but no. It's authored with JavaScript, and actually it's written in TypeScript. And the UI is HTML, but it's not really a website.
Okay, so it runs natively on the desktop inside of a web browser container, but it's not actually a website. It's more complex than that.
It depends on how you define a web browser container, but kind of. I mean, basically there is a web control that hosts all of the UI and, you know, all of the code that VS Code is. So yes, kind of.
So I'm writing JavaScript with JavaScript?
That is true. You're writing JavaScript with JavaScript.
Sounds very much like Inception.
It's, yeah, I guess.
Like, how do we know this isn't a dream?
It's a good point.
Number three, one of the very powerful features of Visual Studio Code is the extensive extensions ecosystem. What are some of the things that I can do with extensions in Visual Studio Code?
Well, I mean, a lot of people use it to theme their editor because they like certain colors or things like that.
I like colors.
Yeah, colors are good, yeah. But also people do, you know, add additional capabilities. So people have color pickers or things like that that they want to show up in the editor. All of the debuggers and language services are actually extensions of Visual Studio Code as well. And then anything that you might want in terms of like deploying to Azure or something like that, additional capabilities are also extensions in VS Code.
Now, I've heard that one of the most popular extensions is the simple React Snippets extension.
That's the one you wrote, Burke.
Maybe?
Yeah. What did I tell you?
Oh, sorry. Number four, you can build for Azure directly from Visual Studio Code. But how does that work? How can you build for the cloud from a text editor?
Well, I mean, anytime that you build a website, you build it locally first, right? And then you deploy it to where you want it to go to. So you can do that with Visual Studio Code. But even easier, you could go to the extensions list and just search for Azure, and you'll see like 25 different extensions that make it easier to build for Azure.
So after I install simple React Snippets, I can install some Azure extensions. But what all can I do with Azure extensions?
You could do pretty much everything, actually.
So
you
can deploy apps?
Yeah, you can deploy, publish. You can look at your storage. You could create a new Azure function. You could debug that Azure function. There's like a lot of stuff you can
do. Wow. Have you ever actually seen Azure?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, have you seen it? It's a huge computer?
No, it's like a lot of huge computers, yeah.
Are you sure? I thought it was just one large, it's like this large.
Depends on how you define computer, but it's actually a lot of computers.
It's more than one computer?
Yeah, I've actually been to the data center. It's like huge.
So it's a lot of computers.
A lot of computers, and like a lot of coolers.
Who put these notes together? I look like an idiot up here. Number five, Visual Studio Code now features something called Live Share, which is like coding with friends. What is Live Share and how does it work?
Basically, it's like you can share the context of the code that you're writing without actually having to do screen sharing. So if I wanted you to help me with like a bug that I was working on, I just need to click share and give you the link. And then you can put that into your version of VS Code and you get all of my code on your VS Code. And we can actually launch into a shared debug session together.
Wow, so you can actually fix my code
before
I force push it to GitHub.
Yes, I can actually see what you type if you're sharing.
You don't want to see my code, it's really bad.
I believe it.
I'm Burke Holland.
I'm Amanda Silver.
And now you know five things about Visual Studio Code.